here again, and she's here to stay. So happy October, everyone. Finally, it's spooky season. So today, I thought I'd start off with a spooky, well, not a spooky story, but a Halloween spooky season themed story. So, this was actually last year. So last year I was Princess Peach for Halloween, and I had this cool costume. It's actually like 6 feet tall, technically, but with the hoop skirt, it has a hoop skirt. It's like, I'm trying to think, it's like about, it'd be about, it's a size small if you put the hoop skirt on. So it's like this, it's like a real, it's cool. So, sorry, I'm looking for my marker. Okay, 64. So, I had got this costume. I was so excited. I was like, oh, maybe Halloween will be less freezing this year, so I can actually wear my costume and not be dying of the cold. This is the wrong color. So I got it all on. I was like, okay, this looks good. Yada, yada, yada. Struggled to get out the door. We got outside. It was freezing cold. One of the coldest Halloweens it has ever been, I think. And I just, like, was like, well, great. And I was like, I'm prepared to suffer. I will be fine. I will not, you know, I will not submit to the cold. But immediately, I was like, okay, I need a coat. So one of my friends is really nice. Her mom brought an extra coat. So she let me use that one because it was too late to go inside. So we started walking, you know, we did our trick-or-treating. About towards halfway to maybe the end, I don't know, it was either halfway or three-fourths of the way, my hands were really, really cold. So luckily one of the moms had brought an extra pair of gloves and she let me use those. So that was super nice. So, you know, I put my gloves on, I was like, phew, my hands are cold now, or not cold, my hands are okay now. So we got back, or we went to my other friend's house at the end, because we kind of start at my house and then go to my other friend's house. So we were at her house, and I was taking off my coat and everything because it was warm, and then when we started taking off my gloves, I noticed these gloves had fit me perfectly before, and I was like, wait, they're hard to get off. Why? And we pulled them off, and my fingers were huge. The cold had made them swell up so much. I could kind of bend them, like, maybe this far. Like, I could bend them pretty well, but it hurt. And then, when I ran them under warm water, because I was supposed to, like, you know, warm them up so they didn't completely freeze over, I could bend them even less. It was, like, this far. And I was, like, freaking out, because I was like, oh my gosh, no, my fingers. I was like, I thought I had frostbite. I was like, I have frostbite, I'm gonna lose my fingers. But luckily, they were okay. So when I started feeling like better, like my fingers started getting a little less cold, we went over and all started, you know, dumping out our candy and sorting it. And everyone in our group got cough drops. Like, cough drops, like Walgreens cough drops. It said Walgreens on it, and we were just like, what the heck? Who gave kids cough drops for Halloween? And all our parents were like, no, 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 don't eat any of those, you know, don't do that. And I literally got six. And so that's basically the end of that story. My pumpkin that year, I got to pick it, what we carved it as, and I picked Peppa Pig. So I thought that this, like any sane person would, making their Halloween pumpkin Peppa Pig. So I do have pictures of the cough drops and of my pig, and of my pumpkin. Peppa Pig pumpkin? Pig pumpkin? Peppa. So, but I don't really want to, I don't want you guys to see my password or photos of my family, friends, and me, because, you know, it's rude to show pictures of them without their consent. So yeah, plus I don't want to get up to get my phone. So that's our spooky story for today. And something also really sad happened. So there's this one craft store in my town, and it's so I had to let him in the door. So, like I was saying, this craft store is going out of business, and it is, like, the only craft store, like, in our entire little town. Like I mentioned in the previous video, I live in kind of a small town, so I almost cried when I heard that, because, like, one, I didn't really want to drive far to go to, like, Joann's or Michael's or whatever, and two, this place, like, I had been there since I was little, and it was always fun, and they had a lot of candy, and it's just sad to see it go. I actually went there recently, because they're still technically open, and so I made a skirt, right? Like I said, I make things, I can sew and do stuff, as you saw with my little Among Us plushie that I made. So I had worn a skirt that day, a pumpkin-y themed skirt that I made, and I had put, like, I had wore my, like, really long socks that I have there, and these two girls just looked at me like I was the weirdest person, and they were, like, my age, so I just, giving me, like, you know, that judgy, harsh, mean stare. So I just stared back at them. I was just like, you're gonna stare at me and be rude, so I'm gonna stare at you. And so I'm sad that that place is closing down. Okay, I don't... How have your guys' day been? I don't know. Like I said in the last video, I'm kind of flustered. I'm just, like, you know, not used to recording my voice. Don't entirely know what to talk about. But I don't want to plan a script, because I feel like it's more fun to just kind of talk. So this is my character Esmerelda that I'm drawing. I've actually got basically three versions of her. The first, she was like kind of a normal looking witch, you know, not a super weird, like, crazy outfit. Hold on. Crazy outfit witch. She kind of like was your generic witch. Like, that's what her outfit basically screamed, I guess. And I made her 2 years ago. And it was, like, for Halloween. And that was when I first got my ohoohoos. Actually, no, then I would have made her last year, because I didn't get my ohoohoos 2 years ago. I got them last year. So I designed her that year, and she was kind of a basic witch. You know, she wasn't interesting. She was just kind of, oh, hi, I'm a witch. I look like a witch. So then I changed her. She still looked like a witch, but more like a flowy cape. Less, she didn't have a witch hat. She was more like a sorcerer or something. You know, like a sorcerer. Less like a witch, more like a sorcerer or sorceress. I don't know what you'd call it. But then, this is her now. I made her hair white, short. She used to have long, flowy black hair. And now she's got the hat again. She also used to have brown hair when I first designed her, so she was super basic witch. Like, super basic. Like, black clothes, you know? Like, black clothes, green and purple, blah, blah, blah. I like her a lot better now. I know that her hat, like, I feel like I've seen a picture somewhere of an anime character with a hat similar, except, like with the eyes and the mouth, except, or actually, I don't think that it has a mouth. Yeah, I think it's just got, like, eyes, but I think they're both circles. And I was like, oh. Because I think that's where where I got the inspiration. I didn't obviously want to copy the hat, because that'd be copying. I just, because I used no reference. I just drew a hat and drew a face on it. Boom. Thought process of the century. I'm the most, I totally have plans when I do things. I forgot. Let me grab my sketchbook. Okay. So, I forgot her color. Okay, so, this is the yellow eye. So, this is red. And this is red. I didn't want to color it wrong. So, I want to know in the comments, like, what your suggestions or what you think. Just kind of your general opinion on, like, how I'm doing so far. Or, like, please do guess, try and guess my favorite character. Like, I would like to see who you guys think my favorite OC of mine is. I think that'd be a fun thing. So I'm just kind of, like I said last time, I'm flustered. I'm excited. Oh, her skirt is diamonds. Not, that's why I needed to look at the picture. So, just gonna draw on some diamonds that don't look right. Do do do. This is one of, I definitely like her design a lot more now than I did in the past. Because when I first made her, I was like, this is the coolest witch in the world. And now I'm just like, ew, her outfit was so basic and she had no personality, like, whatsoever. She didn't seem like an interesting character. But now she seems like she's kind of full of life, looks very energetic. And I like it more. And I like her hat, too. Now, some of you probably could be wondering, like, oh, why didn't she do an Inktober drawing? Inktober just started. Well, I already did it. I already colored my Inktober thing early because I used those liners that I have. They're over these. I used a blue one because I have no purpose for those markers or liners, really. And they say liners, and I have, like I said, I have no purpose, so I just kind of, like, I don't know, just wanted to use them, so I just thought, hey, why not just use them for Inktober, right? I'm not breaking the Inktober rules because I'm still using liners. I don't know, I see some Inktober people who make, like, amazing things, or who, like, use the bottles of ink and then just, like, oops, wrong side. Who then just use, like, they just, like, use the bottles of ink and, like, place it perfectly and don't mess up. And I'm like, how in the world did you just do that? Like, I thought Inktober was just, oh, you only draw in, like, pen or liner or whatever. Or, you know, like, you only, like, either you sketch first and you take the liner and you just draw it or whatever, you know, like, thought it wasn't really supposed to be like, oh, all of a sudden there's just this big thing of ink. I would assume that I'd probably just spill it all and it wouldn't work. I definitely think that any marker that doesn't have, I think it's weird if a marker, like an actual art marker, exists that isn't double-sided. Like, they at least have to have the bullet nib. But, like, chisel nibs are kind of necessary. Because, like, I think they do a really good job covering, like what I'm doing now. Like, big chunks of just open space. And then I just get the finer details with the bullet nib part. I would like your suggestions in the comments. Like, that would be amazing. That would help me out so much, like, what you'd want to see. So, I know I told you guys last time that I was super excited for Melody's thing. So, I just, like, today, I just, like, checked the mail, and then I checked it once today, and then I think I'm gonna go check it again, because I think my brother forgot to. So, I've just been kind of, like, I'm just so excited. I want to see what she did for me. And it's like, just, it's so cool. Because it's like, wow, the internet has really just allowed us to connect and communicate and meet new people all over the world. And it's just crazy that, like, y'all like my stuff. Because, you know, I wanted to start a YouTube channel for a while, but I never really got into it. I just kind of was like, no, I was like, I'm too scared, or people won't like it, or I'll get no subscribers, I'll never get big, or anything, and y'all have just been so nice to me. It's just so, I was about to say no, so nice, but then that sounded like, just so nice, so nice. So, I know that in my first video, I had that big old chunky brace, well, like a cast on my wrist. It was technically a wrap, but like it like was a wrap, but they put a splint in it so it stood still. Like it was a cast. It had some hard parts and then it was squishy. It was a weird, it just went on my hand basically. I don't know. So, and then you saw that I had the what is that thing called? Oh my gosh. The brace. Yeah, that's an actual brace. So then you saw that I had the brace on my hand. So those were because I had this weird bump on my wrist, and it's called a ganglion cyst. So basically it was like when I bent my wrist, there was a big bump coming out, and it's just a sack of like fluid, and I could either get it drained or removed. But if you get it removed, it has a less high chance of coming back. So I just did that because I didn't want it to come back because it hurt, and I'd have to like pop my wrist a lot to get it not to hurt. So I think it's really good that I got it removed. And I used to be able to freak a bunch of kids out with it. Like, I'd bend my wrist and they'd all be like, ugh, you know, like, just like, ah, stop, what is that? And one time when I showed my friend, she just thought it was, she thought it was my bone, and that I was, like, my wrist was extra skinny for some reason, and she just said, girl, eat a sandwich. And that was hilarious, that was funny. I also just kind of want to know, like, what you guys, like, what stories you'd like to hear, because I have a lot of stories. But I don't know, I guess. Just please leave me suggestions. I would really like them. It'd make my day to know that you guys care about the content that I'm making. Well, I mean, obviously I care too, but like, you know, like, guys giving me suggestions. Y'all are also free to critique my art whenever you like. I think it's nice to get critique. Because, you know, it helps. It helps you grow as an artist. And I just remember, like, where I start, or if I look at, like, my really old sketchbook, I just all want to throw it in the trash can, and I actually might, because some of it's really old and just takes up useless space, but, like, my Ohuhu package is getting in the way, and I have nowhere to put it. Maybe I'll do a workspace tour one time. I do want to film the outside a little, like, oh, sorry, you guys can't see that, like, just stand on my deck and film on the clouds before it gets super dark, because as you have seen in my other videos where I filmed the sky, it was, like, pitch black. Yeah, those were all, one of them, it was, like, raining and lightning super crazy, like, not actually raining, but, like, the lightning, and it was, like, the wind was blowing, and then the second time, it was just crazy wind. There was also a siren in the background, so that kind of sucked. But, like, I would like to film, I might film after I film this, because those videos only take, like, 20 seconds. Because it's really pretty. It's actually really cold, but, like, it's pretty. And, like, last month, this hoodie fit, and now look, it's, like, super short on me. And I was like, what the heck? And then I was like, well, what hoodies am I gonna get? I don't wanna go out and really buy. And then I remembered, oh, yeah, I have my merch hoodies that I can get. So if you don't know, Teespring actually lets you order samples where you only have to pay for shipping, so you really only have to pay $3. Like, you can, like, if you said, like, oh, I would like to order a sample, you can just get it for free. And that's if you're a, that's only if you create something, like, if you're the creator, you can say, oh, I want to order a sample, and then you can, like, wear it in your video and be like, ha ha ha, buy my merch, I'm a super cool YouTuber, or whatever. I don't know, that sounded weird. My voice was like, I just want to know, like, I don't know, I told y'all last time, I'm flustered, I'm just like, I don't know what to say. Well, I guess I could talk about school a little. is anyone else doing the online school thing, and do you agree, or do you also think that it kind of sucks, or isn't really as good? Like, I feel like it's not as fun, because I find myself getting off track sometimes, and just kind of like, you know, staring at the sky or whatever, because I don't sit at this specific table, but we set up a table next to this one that's, like, where I do all my schoolwork, and it's just got a bunch of, like, crafts and, like, all my schoolwork just thrown on it. But I just kind of miss being at school. I miss seeing all my friends. So I'm excited for when we get to go back. Hopefully, before, like, Christmas break or whatever, because there's a dance that they do for my school, and I wanted to go to that, and they also have cool field trips. I just remembered something super cool I want to talk about. Sixth grade camp. It was so cool. I feel bad that all the sixth graders this year don't get to do it, because, you know, school being shut down and all, but, like, it was so cool. So, basically, we all go to this camp, and they have toilets in it. They're supposed to be, like, kind of cozy little cabins, and we just camp, but it's not, like, regular camping, because we did this thing called geocaching. I don't know if you know what it is. You get a geocaching device, and you type in coordinates, and you just, like, go to that place and go and try and find a marker or whatever, and then go to the next. And this was funny, because we were all put in teams, and there were, like, maybe 24 stations. So me and my partner just kind of, you know, we were there, and the teachers were like, you're not allowed to run. Running isn't allowed. Which is weird, because we were literally in the wilderness. How do you not expect us to just run? Like, we were in the open outdoors. So they're like, no running. That's not allowed. You shouldn't run. That's, I guess, disrespectful to run on the ground. So me and my partner completely kind of disregarded those rules. Because immediately, my partner, like, took off. Well, not immediately, but we kind of, like, walked out of sight of the teachers, and then we just started sprinting, because we knew we couldn't get anything done if we walked. So we went to, like, the first place, and, you know, we kept geocaching, walking around and stuff, and one time, we literally sprinted right by the teachers, and they were staring at us, and they didn't yell at us to stop. They were just, like, they just stared, like, eh, whatever, what are we gonna do? So I thought that was kind of funny, that they didn't really care that we were just running when they were like, no running, and then some kids were like, you're not allowed to run, but we were just like, you can't get anywhere or win the prize, because I think there was a little prize, and it was like, you can't win the prize or really do anything without running. So we, like, it was crazy, it was interesting. We were just like booking it everywhere, like, we'd find one, we'd cash it, and then we'd just book it. It was fun to kind of, like, look around the buildings and explore the camp. It was a big camp. We made these things called brown bears? Yeah, brown bears. And they were just, like, so what you do is you, like, take sugar. So you get, like, a biscuit, and you dip it in butter. And first you get a stick, cover the stick in foil, and then wrap your biscuit around the stick with the foil. And then, once that's kind of securely, you pinch it a little just so that it sticks, but not so that all the holes break through. And then you dip it in butter, roll it in sugar, roll it in, like, cinnamon, and then you cook it over a fire. And it all, like, oh, it smells so good, and then they taste amazing. They're like, you should try them. I have so many camping stories. Because, like, I was in Girl Scouts. I used to be. I'm not in Girl Scouts. Scout stories, so comment if you'd like to see or hear about any of those. So, I guess back to the 6th grade camp. So, you know, there were a bunch of activities. We were all moving around, looking at wildlife or whatever, you know, whatever. We actually got the farthest in the geocaching, but then this other group was like, we got 20. So, we were literally 4 away from, like, winning. And these other people were like, oh, we got 19. And they were walking the whole time. And me and my partner both knew that there was no way they got to 19 just by walking. So, we knew they were lying, but obviously, we didn't call them out. I mean, it was just 6th grade camp. We didn't care. We were just having fun. It was hard to sleep that night, though, because it was cold. I mean, they were heated cabins, but they were, like, you know, they were pretty classy cabins, but not, like, the highest class cabins. I could sleep pretty well there, though. I should have claimed top bunk, but my friend did. That was fun, though. All the cabins looked cool, and then, trying to remember, I feel like I did something really cool there. Oh, yeah, we did archery. That was okay. I did make a little bead guy. Like, you know, like one of those bead pets where you, like, pass the string in between, and everyone else was just, like, making, like, little bracelets, and then they saw me just making this full-on, like, cute little guy, and they were all like, whoa, that's cool, and I was just like, yeah, it's a lizard, and that was basically that whole archery story. Another kid knocked over my water bottle. That was annoying, like, in the dirt, and there was no soap to clean it, but I just washed off the nozzle. The food there was actually pretty good. I remember just scorfing down a bunch of fries, because at my school, they oven bake the fries, so they're healthier, but they still have, you know, a bunch of grease and fat on them. But the problem with the oven baking is that they put them on one of those heating trays, so by the time you get out of the lunch line, they're freezing cold. So they had actually, like, fried those fries like a normal person, so we were just like everyone licked their little fry cups clean. We were all like, good French fries. We were lucky because there's kind of like this thing in my school where it's two teams. So there's like, you know, like there's two halves of all our hallways look the same for all the grades. And then they split them in half. And then one half went at the beginning of the week. And the other half went on Thursday and Friday. And I was so lucky that I got to be the group that went on Thursday and Friday. Because then after I was tired from just, you know, being at school or being at camp, I just got to go home while all the other kids had to just suffer and do school. And it was really weird to walk through the hallway and only half the students be there, because, like, what the heck? It's like, where's 150 of the kids? That's about how many kids are in. Well, there's about 300 kids on each side. We have a big school. So, I do want to talk really quick again about markers. That's really just to say, I remember last time I was, the wire. I can't, no, get out of the way, wire. So, for the last video, I remember I was, like, talking to you guys about markers, I think. Yeah, markers. I was saying, I remember I said my only complaint about the Ohuhus, and then I said, like, another complaint, but I mean, that's fine. So, do not, like, these markers, like I said last time, do not get these. They really are not that good. Like, they really aren't. Like, they're fine, I guess, if you want, like, you know, if you're just kind of looking for, like, a real quick, cheap marker, but they, like, bleed, like, really bad if they hit each other sometimes. Like, not, like, really bad. Oh, what did I messed up. Now she's got rings around her eyes. It's fine. So, like, they kind of, like, if you used the black to outline your drawing because you wanted a thick, more cartoony look to your line or whatever, and you go over and you're coloring next to it, it will smudge, and it is the most unforgiving, ugly smudge ever. It's just like, ugh, why? So that's kind of annoying. Just do not really get these. They're not that good. I don't know. I did make a Discord, and I want to know if I should, like, post it for you guys or whatever, or, like, you know, make a Google Classroom, because I know, like, Melody was doing a Google, like, she made a Google Classroom. So I want to know if I should do a Google Classroom, or if I should just do a Discord, or, like, what? You know, like, what should I do? Oh, yeah, this is the marker that looks like it's supposed to be, like, baby blue or whatever, and then... Here, watch. That is not baby blue. That is a cyan. That is an Among Us crewmate cyan. It's just like, what the heck? Like, I said this last night. Like, I was like, oh, yes, this is a baby blue. And then it's just an intense cyan. And I was like, now that makes sense. Oh, God. Shade. I don't mind my super markers too much. I think they're just kind of there. Ooh, I know a question. What Animal Crossing villager is your favorite? My favorite is Marshall, and you know what? My first camper on my island in New Horizons was Marshall, and I, like, freaked out. And I was like, yes, you are coming to my island. New Horizons is actually the first Animal Crossing game I've ever, like, owned. Like, I did have the Amiibo Festival one, where you, like, that's a board, it's like a board game, and it's actually super cute and really fun. But, like, you know, I never was really interested, because I felt like sometimes they change too fast, or I just didn't really want one. But then, when I saw some of the New Horizon TikToks on YouTube or whatever, I was just like, this game is, like, beautiful. And it also just looked fun, and I was like, about time I get an Animal Crossing game, because no one in my family really likes it, and, like, my dad was like, he got one, and he, for some reason, like, he gave it to my brother, and my brother just, like, he didn't do, his house still had a cockroach in it, so, we were, like, little, we didn't really want to play or whatever, or we didn't really care, but, like, now I like it, and I think it's, why is this, what color, 53, crap, sorry, I grabbed 53, and I was looking for 57, 50 is too dark, bear with me, this is 57, isn't it? This is 57. This doesn't even look like 57. Would you guys ever like to see a sewing video or something? Or, like, I don't know. Can I find a color in between this, please? Going once. Going twice. Sold to the... cyan that I shall just use because I do not know what else to do. Would you guys like to see, like, a sewing video or something? Because I've, like, you know, got a couple sewing projects going. I've just kind of been coloring, just kind of, you know. Let me know if you'd like to see an actual Inktober thing, because I haven't really been, like, super going crazy with Inktober. I've just kind of been like, yeah, I'll do this. This seems pretty fun. Look, okay, the only super marker that I have seen that does not look like it. This one says fuchsia, but you know, fuchsia really is this color. It's a little more mellow in real life. It looks like a hot pink. But fuchsia's lid should not be, this is like purple. This is fuchsia. Like, they should have made, it's so bright on camera. They should have made this the color of the cap. So that's kind of like, it's like, well, why? why'd you do that? And then this one that's supposed to be purple. This one actually kind of looks how it's things. This is not the right color. This goes here. The green potion goes here. So now I just have to look with that purple spot sitting there. Alrighty. We're almost at the end. I like these gel pens. You can get them for pretty cheap, just like 3 of them or whatever, just on Amazon, and it's like, yes. Because I think they work so well, and I think they leave such a nice shine. Like what Mariah Elizabeth says, the shine is always the best part. It just always looks so pretty, and I feel like it adds the finishing touch to the drawing. I'm trying to see if there's any more places where shining would look good. But there's not. So, I'll sign this in green, I guess, because this is the only pen. This pen is dying, that is wonderful. Alrighty, so, that is the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed. Please comment down below what you'd like to see next, or just any suggestions or critique. And have a good day.